Welcome to the Cheryl and Vicki Talk Show. I'm Dr. Cheryl Jackson.
And I'm Vicki Atkins.
And as always, we're here to help you wake up happy.
I'm here with my fabulous sister,
V. How are you doing, Vicki?
I'm fantabulous.
I mean, you look fantabulous. You just made up your word, huh?
Fantabulous. I did. Yeah, I did.
Yeah,
I
you know what?
I just made it up, right? How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling, my mother made up a word. It was quasi-atonement Monique.
What does that mean?
I knew you would ask that. I have to go back and read, but it was something about really being happy and exciting and dynamic.
That's over the top.
Yeah, and she used that to describe the members of the church, and she was like, quasi-atonique. It was something like that. I'll find it.
Is that a Q? Does it start with a Q?
It starts with a Q, and I cannot spell the rest of it.
Okay, good.
But it's good. My mother had a fantabulous vocabulary, right? How have you been? So has anybody approached you yet saying, I saw you on the Cheryl and Vicki show, and you said, I'm Vicki, not Cheryl?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Cheryl. Cheryl, they've approached me. My gosh, my social media is just off the chain. I don't even know what to do with that.
I need help. Yes, she really does need help. And we just want to say thank you because you have been responding. You're responding because we thought we were onto something, having a happy show, but y'all have made us so happy just validating what we are doing, right?
Exactly.
And we're doing something today that I'm really, really excited about because we have these episodes because this show is about empowering women, right? And empowering our community and really, really connecting because what happens is people say, how are you doing? And do you ever notice they never stop
to find
to
out
really
how,
see
you're
how you're
doing?
So sometimes I literally say, when somebody says, how are you doing? I'm like, I'm not doing good. I'm feeling sick. Just to see if they'll stop. They keep walking right on by. I was like, they didn't even care, Vicki. And so this show is about to just really kind of shine the spotlight on some of the things that we do and we say that we could probably do just a little bit better. Do you agree?
I totally agree. Especially when you were going through the drive-thru yesterday and this woman was so rude to Cheryl that I was like almost like very appalled. I was uncomfortable on the other end of the phone. I was like, what's going on? She goes, I need, like, it was a value pack meal. She was, well, if I'm going to spend this much money, then why don't you just throw in an extra fry?
Yeah.
And she's, are you having a bad day? And she's like, no.
No.
How are you?
And she threw it at me.
It was bad.
Yeah. Well, you know what? What would you have done? It was a value pack. The value pack was $7.99, and it was a taco. Okay. I was at Taco Bueno. And it was a Taco Bueno burger. I love taco burgers. And it was a quesadilla, and it was a Dr. Pepper, which you know I love.
Right,
in a taco, and it was $8.99, and so I just ordered a taco burger, and it was $7.49. What would you have done? I said, ma'am, change this to a combo. Make me a combo girl.
Right.
She got mad.
She did get mad.
I said, did I upset you about that? Well, you know what? What I'm not going to get upset about is this episode and this segment that we got coming up, because it's about sisterhood.
It is.
And you invited one of your very, very special friends, Kristy Kerns, and Kristy is right here in the building. And when we talk about sisterhood, we just going to show you what sisterhood, love, and empowerment and celebration of one another looks like. So go ahead, get those Cheerios, get that spoon, and we'll be right back.
CW33 wants to save you money by providing exclusive discounts from the best places in town. Go to cw33.com/discounts to get deals and savings from recognized retailers around DFW. Get real savings on entertainment, beauty services, food, fashion, and a ton of other always fun items and activities. Get a few bucks in savings, get great value, but most of all, get them before they're gone. CW33's deals and discounts exclusively at cw33.com.
You at Girl Scouts. We're together, we can do big things. Make it your year of friendship at Girl Scouts.
If the sun's going down and you don't have a place to stay, don't just make it through the night. Make it to after 8. Make it to a warm meal, a warm shower, and a warm bed. Make it to clean clothes, a listening ear, and a group of people who get it. Make it to graduation, job interviews, trade school, college, or a career that you love. Make it to after 8 tonight so you can start dreaming about tomorrow.
Welcome back, everyone. Our next guest is a cheerleader of dreams. We are thrilled to have Terri Savelle Foy. Welcome to our show.
Thank you. It's an honor.
It's so good to have you here. Oh my gosh, Terri. Talk to us. I've seen you on so many different platforms doing so many different things, but you're here today really to talk about your new book.
Yeah.
It's called The Alone Advantage. And you gave us a copy. We already have our site.
Yes.
This is your 15th book, right?
Yes, 15
books. Tell us about this. How do you find time to write 15 books and I can't get my second one out?
I had to get alone.
You had to get alone.
Get alone.
Exactly.
There you go.
That's exactly.
Good. But nobody wants to be alone, Terri.
No, I was just telling you, if I had been told I would write a book called The Alone Advantage, I wouldn't have believed it.
And I wouldn't have believed. I said you had somebody ghostwrite that because that's not who you are, right?
Right. Like, that sounds like solitary confinement, right?
Sure, it sounds like prison.
Yes.
And you're a cheerleader. How can you be quiet? Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I tell you what, this book, oh my gosh, it came about at the worst time in my life, the whole premise of the book. Just to kind of give you a little backstory, because God's done amazing things in my life and our organization, you know, 15 books and 40 million views on YouTube, and getting to share the stage with my heroes, Les Brown, Ed Milet, John Maxwell,
all of them are in this book.
Yes.
Complimenting you on it. Talk about it.
And that's, I mean, it's just the favor, you know?
That of course.
But to appreciate it, you have to know the backstory.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
So I went through some things that just caused such a poor self-image. And just everything from at 14 years old, being violated by a guy at a fitness center, lost my virginity on a gym floor by a complete stranger.
I'm sorry.
And I don't know if you've ever heard this phrase that you behave in a manner consistent with how you see yourself.
Right. Yes.
I saw myself as worthless, so I started letting people treat me like I'm worthless.
Mm.
Got into an abusive relationship for 2 years. Finally got out of that. Senior year of college, I got pregnant before marriage.
Oh.
3 weeks later, I get married. 3 weeks after the wedding, I lose the baby. So for 11 years, I just sunk down into a rut.
Yeah.
You know, just existing. I was busy, very busy, worked hard. Mm. But I didn't have any dreams or goals. Yeah. Didn't know my value. So 11 years later, it's 2002, and my husband and I just hit rock bottom. And we separated.
Mm.
And we've been living paycheck to paycheck, no money in our savings account, you know, just existing.
Yes.
Well, my dad, who was my boss at the time, he knew what I was going through, and he said, he's my favorite. But he said, I want you to just work from home temporarily, alone. And when he said the word alone, it just sounded like misery.
Right.
Well, I found out that was the very thing missing in my life. I never spent time alone to think, to dream, to imagine my life in the future.
Right.
So I flew to New Orleans to visit a friend, and her dad, who was a minister, he knew what I was going through. And he just spoke 4 words to me that gave me direction.
Tell us, please.
He said, you work on you.
You work on you. That's beautiful.
I got home from that and I started listening to Joyce Meyer, and I heard her make this statement. She said, God will change your circumstances. I was like, oh, thank you, Lord.
Yes, exactly.
She said, but he'll change you first.
Then I
heard Jim Rohn, the great motivator. He
yes.
said, if you want the future to change, you've got to change. I was like, why is everybody pointing at me?
It's all about me. I didn't do anything,
yes.
right?
My shoulders aren't that big.
Exactly, but I took it to heart. And that first morning, I took my little girl to kindergarten. I walked in the empty house. I picked up a journal and a pen.
A big one,
Texas-sized pen.
Yes, Texas-sized. Yes.
Yes, and I sat on the couch. And what I did next led to 15 books.
Wow, bravo.
My marriage restored.
Bravo.
Speaking in arenas across America.
Yes.
Here's what I found out.
What?
People are rewarded in public for what they practice in private.
Oh, say that again. That's so good.
People are rewarded in public for what they practice in private.
Right.
Powerful. What you do behind the scenes has more significance than what you do in front of a crowd.
Mm.
So I discovered 10 habits behind the scenes that drive crazy success.
And you know, we don't have a lot of time. time, so exactly. You got to tell us. Come on, go for it.
So one of the habits is to actually give yourself permission to dream.
I like that.
The power of the pencil.
Yes.
And you know, I heard this from just educating myself in those private hours. Mm. There was a professor at Virginia Tech. He did research on successful people and goal setting.
I love it.
He asked him, he said, what are your goals for life? 80% said, I don't have any goals. So think of 80% walking around with no vision.
Oh, I'm looking at the studio. 16%
said, I have some goals, but I've never written them down. Wow. 3% said, I've written them at some point, but I don't know where they are.
Wow.
1% said, I have goals, I've written them down, and I review them on a consistent basis.
1%.
He said, guess who the 1% were? Millionaires.
That's exactly
every one
who
of them.
They were. Of course it was.
So I began doing what successful people do, and my life moved in that direction.
And now you're here on your 15th book, and
yes.
Life is great, right?
Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
Yeah.
And so I love inspiring women to discover the 10 habits behind the scenes that will drive success.
And where can they go to find the 10, since we didn't have enough time, but we'll definitely invite you back. Where can they go to find those 10 habits?
Yeah, you can just go to terri.com, that's my website, or wherever books are sold.
That's beautiful, that's beautiful. Okay. Terri, your story is truly amazing, and for more information, please visit Terri, T-E-R-R-I.com. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
North Texas is a melting pot of culture, and the Metroplex is filled with fun.
Like line dancing at the Stockyards.
Yeehaw!
Checking out the shops in Sundance Square.
Getting a sweet treat from Andy's in Clyde Warren Park.
Or enjoying the beautiful murals of Bishop Arts.
There is so much to see and do around the Metroplex, and we're taking you with us to explore everything that's fresh, unique, and new in DFW.
Inside DFW and Fun on the Run, weekdays on CW 33, always fun.
Day one, diagnosis day, the hardest day, the day you hear,
I'm sorry, this is a type of blood cancer.
But day one is just one day. At the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, we are here to help you move past day one.
On day 45, I discovered an online community who shared great tips for in-treatment care.
On day 185, LLS helped me file my insurance claims properly.
We are here for you. We exist for everyone fighting leukemia, lymphoma, myeloma, and other types of blood cancer.
LLS provided immediate financial support that helped me keep my business going through treatment.
To learn more and get help on day one, day two, day 983, or any day.
Day 5,840 and counting, and I'm still in remission.
Please visit lls.org or call 1-800-955-4572.
Donors choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
At donorschoose.org, we want students in every community to have the tools they need for a great education. And now, more than ever, students and teachers need your help. Every year, most public school teachers spend nearly $500 of their own money on student supplies. Let's do the math. That comes out to over $1.2 billion. We can do better. Here's how. Go to donorschoose.org, find a request to support, and we'll make sure they get exactly what they need. Choose from books to computers, from art supplies to robotics kits. There are microscopes, musical instruments, and so much more. You'll receive thank you letters and photos from students and teachers, and a report of how every dollar was spent. To learn more and find a teacher's request in your community, visit donorschoose.org.
Donors choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
Welcome back. Sister V and I are so excited about our next guest, and we're excited because we both know her, right, Sister V?
We do. Carla Shellis.
Yes, Carla Shellis. And Carla is the CEO and founder of BOCHY.org. Welcome, Carla, to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's an honor.
I feel like I'm at home with you guys.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's been some years, but the tapestry just got woven back around.
I mean,
with the three of us, this is so powerful.
I love it.
You know what I love about your organization? You started it in memory of your mom.
Yes,
talk
just
about
like
that.
You did.
Yes,
well,
yes.
My mom is Bochy, and the heartbeat of my mom was family and tradition and heritage and love and just the confidence of a woman.
Mm.
And going
confidence.
In, yeah, confidence of a woman. Going in and working with girls that have been exploited to the most horrific levels in sex trafficking. was something I got called into. It was never on my dream board, but I love that that God gave me the opportunity to walk alongside of such brave and strong, courageous women, and it lifted my lid.
Right,
you know?
It did.
Takes all the excuses away when you see these girls come back from that type of work, and so
But is it frightening? Because the work that you like, I feed the hungry, and that's okay. And you're writing scholarship checks to kids and students, but we're talking about sex trafficking, which is like
that's a big deal.
It is. It's a very scary world. We work more in restoration. We support some rescue organizations as well, but we do. We brought the girls in to a safe place and restored them over about 18 months' time.
Right. Wow.
And we have some huge success right now. We have some girls that are just doing amazing things and out there doing great. Now we're focusing on transition.
That's beautiful.
And which is getting them back into life successfully.
And what has that been like? What's that like for them and for you?
Well, it's amazing because we basically start at ground zero.
Okay.
And when we start to build them back to a knowing of who they are, then we can extract from them their dreams and their goals and their vision. What did God create you for? And then launching them out in that and watching that start to break cycles.
And I can only imagine the look on their faces when you say, I'm going to pull you out. But not only am I going to pull you out, but I'm going to push you up and help you see who you're supposed to be. What does that make your heart feel like when you're doing those connections?
You guys, we always say we do a hand up, not a hand out.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so the first requirement was you got to want to be made well. Jesus said that,
absolutely.
Didn't he?
He
to
did
the man
say,
by the well.
You know,
you got to
preach too,
to be well. You gotta want that.
Mm.
So there is nothing more rewarding than seeing a shrapnel of a human being put back together and walk out and do successful life. And so now what we're doing is we're focusing on the inner city youth. Because there's a lot of problems of exploitation right in the middle schools. We're working with 12 and 13 year old girls. But we finally decided.
We've got a problem.
We decided if I can get them to believe who they are and whose they are, if they can be in charge of their own integrity and their own value, then they themselves are going to keep themselves out of the rat race.
There's greatness in every one of us, but you've got to know that there is greatness.
That's right.
And that you can tap into it and develop into the kind of person and character that you're called to be.
Well, you know, we were just talking about etiquette. You and I were just talking about etiquette.
We were. Talk about that, because on your Instagram, you're teaching them all things etiquette. Actually, you're teaching me too.
This is the thing.
Can we sign up?
We did a whole dining class with some of the girls at this inner school.
That was so beautiful.
There are 25 of them. And oh my gosh, we were in tears because we took them to a nice dinner afterwards, and we were able to watch them use all the skills that I taught them in the class before. And it's just simply how to use a napkin, what every utensil is. But when you have a tool set and it makes you feel equipped, it rises you above a certain level of thinking.
Right.
And when your thinking is higher, then your life is higher.
Exactly.
And so that's kind of our foundation, is we're working to provide now with the inner city youth and then transitional care for the girls we've already pulled out of exploitation.
Yeah, well, you know, this is Women's History Month, and to me what you're doing is part of empowerment.
That's right.
You're teaching etiquette, and I will tell you that when I'm sitting sometimes at some of the most prominent places, I used to be afraid, and I would look around and say, okay, which fork did they pick up for their salad?
Right.
Because I wasn't sure about it.
Right.
And when you are sure about it, you can walk in and sit next to the president of all of these companies and be confident and say, this is who I am. And they're like, oh, that little girl knows something. I'm like, I sure do, but I'm still waiting to make sure you pick up the right fork too, right?
Well,
but you're teaching it.
I mean, it's a tool. Etiquette means little signs to tell you the way that you should go.
Mm. Right.
It's not like a dictatorship or a rule. It is little signs to tell you in the way that you should go, and it is a tool because you're not going to need that at Chick-fil-A.
You're not.
You're fine at Chick-fil-A.
No, don't be
but
talking
But when you're
Chick-fil-A
sitting down at
burger.
A five-star dinner and you're around other people, if you feel equipped, and I've had graduates out of my program years and years, I've been doing this for almost 10 years, call me and say,
thank you.
Thank you for teaching me that. I went to my boss's Christmas party, and I feel like I belong. I knew how to use my napkin. I knew how to sit up and stand up and shake hands.
Wow.
That's worth everything to me.
Do you have any events coming up that we can support you in?
Well, right now we're just getting ready to relaunch the whole brand. I have a show coming out too very soon.
Okay.
We don't have it signed yet, so I can't say, but just following us on social media, Carla Shellis, and then at BOCHY's, we're letting a lot of new stuff come out in the next few months.
That's so beautiful.
Are you always bringing in new people? Always.
Well, not into the safe house anymore. We're working more in transitional care.
Okay. Yeah,
so we have three girls who've graduated the program that we're now equipping to stand up and get out into
and
jobs.
Now they can help. Each one
education.
Reach one.
Yes. We've got two being educated, one being a full-time job, and it's amazing.
I am so proud of you.
It's amazing. I love doing it.
And I love your party, so I can't wait. I think you're having one soon, and I'm coming to the party.
She is the queen of parties. I've been there, and you invite everyone.
Yes, right. You know what I love is, what can I get you to drink? And you pull out that drawer with every drink in the universe, right?
You know why? Let me tell you, I'm Mexican American, so I am all about hospitality.
Okay.
If I can make you feel loved and valued when you walk into my space, that I feel like I have accomplished a goal.
Well, you know what?
So that's what I do. I want to provide everything for everybody that walks into my house.
And that's what we want to do when they come into this
house.
Exactly.
That's
right.
Thank you so much for being a guest.
Absolutely.
Yes, thanks for having me, guys. And be sure to follow Carla Shellis on all of her social media, and then visit BOCHY.org website, and you can get more information about the incredible work that you're doing, Carla.
Guys.
Thank you again for coming and being with me and Sister V.
Listen, life can be messy. Your mother says, I don't think I'm your mom.
Yes.
Wow. But that's what I do. You gotta calm down. I had to go through it, and I can help you get through it.
I'm just giving you a hug.
It's why we bring it out and sort it out.
Now that's a boundary!
We dig in. 65 interactions, sexual in nature, and get to the truth.
You chose a man over your family.
And this season is about to get a whole lot messier.
Karamo, weekdays at noon on CW33. CW33 delivers daytime drama as easy as 1, 2, 3.
That sounds like a Jerry Springer show.
At 1, it's Wilco's Gone Wild.
We will not have anybody spitting on anybody, I can tell you that right now.
At 2, Maury deals a blow to deadbeat dad.
You are the father.
And at 3, it's the original Jerry World.
He speaks French to me on milk.
Almost said that.
It's daytime drama delivered at 1, 2, and 3. Weekdays on CW33. Always fun.
CW33 wants to save you money by providing exclusive discounts from the best places in town. Go to CW33.com/discounts to get deals and savings from recognized retailers around DFW. Get real savings on entertainment, beauty services, food, fashion, and a ton of other always fun items and activities. Get a few bucks in savings, get great value, but most of all, get them before they're gone. CW33's deals and discounts exclusively at CW33.com.
If the sun's going down and you don't have a place to stay, don't just make it through the night. Make it to after 8. Make it to a warm meal, a warm shower, and a warm bed. Make it to clean clothes, a listening ear, and a group of people who get it. Make it to graduation, job interviews, trade school, college, or a career that you love. Make it to after 8 tonight so you can start dreaming about tomorrow.
Remember, girls, you decide what makes you happy, not your emotionally withholding mothers.
The Big Bang Theory, weeknights at 6 on CW33.
No! No! Oh, my God. Did she get off the plane? Did she get off the plane?
I got off the plane.
Friends, weeknights at 9 on CW33.
I hope you're as happy as I am, because we had a phenomenal show. And our guest right now is, I mean, she's just going to take us to another level. We're here with the incredible Kristy Kerns. Oh, I said Kristy Kerns. Don't you hate when someone says your name incorrectly? But you are Kristy Kerns, and she's the CEO of Mastering Your Life. Kristy, we had this episode called Sisterhood, and Vicki was like, I want to bring my sister Kristy on. So welcome to the show. How are you doing?
Thank you so much for having me. I'm doing amazing.
Oh,
thank you.
You have such an amazing smile. I see why. Vicki, tell the viewers, look at them. Weren't they adorable? Just happy on this Saturday morning. Why did you want to shine the spotlight on your relationship and friendship with Kristy? Tell us about Kristy.
Because I think it's so important that women invest in other women's lives to see, be able to see them. It's a gift, right? Because we all need that friend. You know, it's just important. And if you don't have friends out there that care about you or see you, take time to be a friend. In order to have a friend, you got to be a friend. And I appreciate you standing by me through some tough times, some highs and lows. You've been on some trips with me, and I just love you, and I adore you, and I thank you for all you do.
I thank you too.
And Kristy, tell me what it feels like to know that you have a girlfriend there at all times, that like what she just said, that sticks by you through thick and thin. What is life like? Because women are always, most of the time, we're competing against each other, which is why we wanted this segment.
It's been priceless, actually. It just makes me want to spread that with everybody, because women definitely deserve that and need that in life. I mean, we don't compete with each other. We lift each other up. We vibe. I mean, we're starting to look like each other. Everybody's like, are you sisters? You know, it's just very, very interesting.
Yeah, she's my older sister. Yeah.
I'll take it.
What's the funnest time you two have had together?
Oh, wow.
Say the same? Look at you both. Which way do we start?
We've had so many incredible times together. I think one of the most hysterical times is when we were on that trip and we were in that holy water, the lava all over our body. Yes. Right? St. Lucia?
Yes.
It was beautiful. Pretty fun. Yeah. And there's just so many memories.
We smelled like that sulfur for days. We could not get it out of us.
The cutest suit that I had throw away.
Yeah, to throw away. And what would you say? We don't have a lot of time left, but what would you speak to the women who are wanting to have a relationship? What does it take to have a relationship like Kristy and Vicky's?
I think just don't compete. Be honest with each other. Love each other unconditionally. That's what we're supposed to do, is love unconditionally. And I have gifts that I bring to the table as the other person does, and just embrace, and you could be, you know, team power and go conquer the world.
And how do you celebrate each other? Tell me about your celebration of you. Look at y'all both. tell her.
Every single day I get a good morning beautiful text. My husband doesn't do that, but that's okay. Bill, I still love you. But to get a friend that is just always going to uplift my day, I know that I'm going to have a word of encouragement coming from Kristy. She loves me on my good days and my bad days. And a friend just doesn't give up on you, even if you've been a stinker. They love covers a multitude, right?
It
keeps no records of wrong. And at the end of the day, love never fails.
It never fails.
And don't give up on people.
Never.
That is so beautiful.
I never give up on you.
That's so beautiful.
I love you too.
Well, I have a friend that's going to come on Sisterhood too. I just want you to know you're not alone, but I celebrate and I want to be a part of your sisterhood. And what would life be like if all the women out there could love, hold hands, and really respect each other? This is Women's History Month. I had a girlfriend that texted me on the first day of our show, and she told me, her name's Katrina, she'll be on one of our upcoming shows, but she just told me how proud she was of me. And I remember looking down and I just felt tears coming, but I was getting my makeup done. I was like, you can't cry. But it made me feel good that my friend saw me and that she was elevating me. And so I celebrate y'all today for your friendship. And I just want to say thank you to all of our viewers. This is such a beautiful relationship. Go out, call your girlfriend. I know you have one or two. Call them, text them, tell them how much you love them, how much you appreciate them. And we've got a great show. We're going to end this show today with one of the motivational speeches that I heard. Or it's just a saying, and it says, if you fall 8 times, just get up 9. So get up today and have a great day.